line for the warm-up presented by Community Sports. I'm Mark Koontz as we talk Marion Local Flyers, joined now by head coach Tim Goodwin. And same old in Marion Local. Another state championship on the big board behind us. Four straight state titles, but 2014's the past. This is 2015. How difficult is it to turn the page and start looking forward to that next season after you win another state title?
I don't think it's difficult at all. I mean, the coaches by nature are always looking forward. They're always projecting forward, you know. And, you know, the players, you know, their memory is even shorter than the coaches most of the time. So it's not a problem at all. You know, it's a new group, new team, new group of seniors, you know, that are hungry for, you know, their last year to be a successful one.
Certainly among the strengths of Marion Local's program is the fact that you guys, for Division Six, we'll get into that a little bit later, but for a smaller school, you don't have to worry about the numbers. You got, 60, 70 kids out playing football for you.
Yeah, we're very fortunate that way. Actually, we have 82 out this year, and you know, that's a great number for a school our size, but more importantly, you know, we got you know, a large group of kids that I think are varsity ready. You know, to go out there at some point and on a Friday night and contribute in some way.
Certainly, when you look at what you have to replace from last year, it starts in the backfield. J.C. Guttermiller, who's so good for you all 4 years of his high school career, he's graduated. Offensively, how does that change your approach going into this year? Does it change the approach?
Well, it doesn't change the approach. The outcomes might be different. You know, but honestly, we probably graduated the best football class in Marion Local history. You know, so. I mean, we know that. Everybody knows that. We're going to be replacing a lot of great players and players that played for 3 years. So as far as our approach, it's the same. You know, we're putting in a bunch of different things, and we're just going to slowly figure out what we can do and what we do well and go with that and try to expand on that part.
Hunter Wilker, one of those returnees who seemingly has played forever here at Marion Local. He is finally a senior and certainly going to be a centerpiece of your team on both sides of the ball.
Yeah, Hunter's one of those kids that, you know, stepped in and played right away as a freshman and was very successful. You know, obviously we're expecting big things from Hunter this year, but at the same point, you know, we know we're going against well-coached teams that, you know, if Hunter's the only guy out there doing anything for us, you know, it's not going to take long for them to stop that. So, you know, as usual, we're trying to develop a balanced approach.
Speaking of big things, perhaps he's been heralded as the next big thing for Marion Local, is your sophomore offensive lineman, John Dirksen, 6'5", 275 pounds, as a freshman last year, made the All-MAC team, which just doesn't happen for freshmen very often, but he did, and he's starting to get a lot of publicity and a lot of hype surrounding around this big young man.
He's a unique kid. You know, he's got pretty much the whole package, you know, the size and the strength and the brains to go with it. So, you know, but he's just a sophomore, so. You know, I'm expecting him to be a great player, but I'm not necessarily expecting him to be a leader. You know, that's what the older guys are for. So, you know, but we're expecting him to go out there and perform well, that's for sure.
As we alluded to this year, Marion Local in Division Six, on one level, it doesn't change things. If you win enough games, you're going to get into the postseason. On another level, though, does that change how you have to start looking at things down the road if you start concerning yourself more with playoff points in that type of situation, or is that something that really, at this point in the beginning of August, isn't a concern?
Well, there's nothing you could do about it at this point, but, you know, in the back of your mind, one, we know it's going to be harder to get in as far as points, and two, you know, just looking at, you know, what some teams have coming back, you know, and just watching who Minster played last year a little bit, you know, we know there's some tough teams in Division Six, so. But that's so far down the road that, you know, we got so many good big games coming up and on our 10 that we know we're playing that there's no reason to look forward any.
Week one on the road to Macomb. Week two at home, Bealsville, team over by the West Virginia border. It's been a struggle the last couple of years to get a week two opponent. You think maybe down the road that you've got that kind of figured out. But starting off with Macomb and Bealsville, that's how you guys are going to get ready for this year.
It is. And, you know, that Macomb game is going to be a huge game for us because you know, we know Macomb is going to be good, and they're going to win games up there. And, you know, that's going to be a huge game for Harbin points either way. And Bealsville, you know, we don't know anything about. They're probably not going to give us, you know, many computer points. So that really puts a lot of onus on that week one Macomb game.
Looking at the rest of the MAC, obviously you've got three defending state champions in this league. Fort Recovery is a little bit of a surprise team last year. Do you think there's another Fort Recovery type team that's going to come out of the MAC this year and make a run?
You know, that'll be interesting. The reason there was a surprise because people didn't see it coming. But actually, you could see the groundswell coming with Fort Recovery, and you can still see it because their younger grades are football-type classes. So it'll be interesting. You know, we have one new coach over in Anna that I can think of right now off the top of my head, and New Bremen has a new coach. It'll be interesting. You know, there's definitely, you know, Minster and Coldwater right there is two defending state champions that even though they lost some, they both got, you know, quite a bit back.
What was the summer like for the Marion local football program?
I think it was a typical summer where, all of June we're working out, we have 100% of our kids there, and, the kids are hungry, and, I think where we're at right now is where we need to be.
As you move forward through August, are there key mileposts in August that you look at saying, okay, we need to have such and such accomplished by the fifth practice, or is it just kind of a gradual process as you get ready for week one?
Yeah, I would say both. You know, you got your punch list that you need to expose your kids to. You know, you need to show your defense all these different looks so they know, and offense, you know, you need to show them, you know, all this things. But on the same plane, you have to see what your team is capable of taking in. You know, you got to feed them as much as possible, but you can't, you know, overload them. So I think it's both.
Your senior class that just graduated played 60 games in their high school careers. They went 15 games all four seasons, something Coldwater's done the last couple years with their senior classes. When you have that many games, does it become complacency of the grind, that type of issue? Does that pop up where you have to try and find fresh ways to keep things new for your team?
I would say that's what's great about this area is you can, and sometimes we do, but I don't feel that we have to, because it's just not our mindset. You know, it's just a blue collar mindset that we have in this area, and our team has taken on that, where, you know, we're going to show up and we're going to work hard and we're going to do our stuff.
As you get ready for Macomb week one, what do you think you need to work on the most between now and that first game?
Well, it'd be hard to pinpoint. We just have so many new guys out there. But just looking at what we have coming back, we lost six out of our front seven on defense. So that, you know, we got to get that defensive front ready to go. We lost our quarterback, so that's always a deal. You know, where you have to get that kid so that the game slows down a little bit. So, you know, I would say those couple things are off the top of my head.
Yeah, Flyers graduated the MAC Offensive Player of the Year, J.C. Gutterell, and the Defensive Player of the Year, Jacob Kunkler. Tim Goodwin, thank you for your time. We're going to take a break here on the warm-up presented by Community Sports. When we return, Patrick Kamler will take over and sit down with a couple of Flyer players here on WOSN.
Welcome back to the warm-up presented by Community Sports. I'm Patrick Kamler, joined with a trio of Marion local seniors. With me right now, Aaron Neatfeld, Kyle Homan, and Justin Bowman. Guys, glad to have you on here. You guys have always had the off-season where you're coming off a state championship. Has this off-season been any different in any way for you guys than any of the other off-seasons? I'll start with you, Aaron.
The only real difference is we're seniors now, so you gotta get the younger classmen going, get them working hard in the off season, and that's really only major role or thing different.
Yeah, and the coaches do a really good job of making sure everybody's working hard and nobody's taking plays off or anything, so it keeps the whole team in check.
Like Aaron said, the only thing that really changes is now everybody's kind of looking at you. You gotta help the younger guys along and get them through it as well.
How has the example that the guys that are no longer here, the guys that have graduated and moved on, how has that helped you set the example for the younger guys?
I always liked to watch Jason Brunswick. He always worked hard in the weight room. He ended up being a big guy. He came a long way in his 6 years of football here. I always liked to watch him as an example.
You guys have just started. Kyle, what specifically have you been working on with getting into practices, and what are you kind of looking forward to with the season progresses and get started?
Just to try to help the younger guys get better and just to make the team better. If you have more players that can play each spot, then you're more have a more depth and you're able to have a better team.
What about you, Aaron?
I like how there's a lot of guys that could potentially play varsity this year, so pushing them to try to earn a spot on the team is really beneficial to our team, and it makes us a lot better.
Last question, season coming up, any particular games you guys are looking forward to that you are starting to circle on the schedule?
Macomb week one is going to be a nice test on the road, week one versus a very tough opponent, kind of looking forward to that one.
Kyle, real quick.
Well, you got to take every week, every team seriously, but you always look for like teams like Coldwater and just the rivals.
Aaron?
I think maybe St. Henry at home this year will be a good one.
Awesome. Well, thanks a lot, guys. When we come back, we'll have a few more Marion local players to talk to right here on the warm-up on WOSN. Welcome back to the warm-up presented by Community Sports. Have a few more Marion local Flyers players with me, a couple more seniors, Hunter Wilker and John Sweeterman. Guys, I'll start with kind of the same thing that I asked the other guys. Hunter, you first. What have you been working on here as we get started in training camp? What are you looking forward to working on?
Just being that role model out there, just showing like the younger kids how to work hard and just how to come out and practice hard every day.
John?
There's a lot of leadership that comes into being a senior, and I'd say just showing all those younger guys how to work hard and how it takes a good work ethic to be out here every day to be playing Marion local football.
You know, Hunter, as the season progressed last year, it seemed like you were the guy that was in a number of different positions. It seemed like you were either catching the ball or running the ball. I may remember you passing it maybe at one point at last year. Has that experience helped you with being more of a leader on the football team this year?
Yeah, it just shows, like, no matter where they put you, just do your best and give it 100% every time.
John, what are you looking forward to most about this upcoming season?
Being a senior, you know, it's your last year, and because of our past, you know, you just want to keep the tradition going. You want to keep rolling with it.
What, for both of you, what does that do for the pressure? Does that make it more? Does that make it less? Do you just kind of roll with it knowing that the guys that have all come before you have all won state titles? And how does that do for your preparation to also want to bring a state title home?
It definitely puts a target on your back knowing, like, the bar has been raised and you just want to keep the streak going and just keep the tradition going.
John, what about you?
Yeah, I agree, but then again, you need to take it day by day, and just it's every day. You just go one step at a time.
You guys have two a lot of good games. This is the MAC, of course. You guys have two state champions that are going to be on your schedule this year. Does that come into play with any of your preparation or how you guys look forward to the season?
We're going to take it practice by practice and get better and better each day.
John?
You know, we're definitely excited to play the other state championship teams, and I think the competition will be fun, and they'll be good games.
John, Hunter, thanks a lot for joining us. That's going to do it for the warm-up here on WOSN. For Mark Kuntz, I'm Patrick Kamler, and we'll see you next time.